Shelly, thank you for being a part of Media Revolutionaries.
Well, I'm delighted to be part of it. I'm delighted to be here.
Now, you have to tell me, how did you get into this business?
Oh, it's crazy. It was a total accident. I was getting a ride with a woman I went to college with down to New York City. And she said, I'm going to some conference on advertising that Advertising Women of New York are putting together. You want to go with me? And I had never thought about advertising as a career ever in my life. And I said, sure. And I went with Sue, and it was went on for 5 hours, this conference. And I could have sat there for another 3 days. I was completely mesmerized by it. I found it fascinating. I never had thought about the fact that there was a strategy behind a commercial, or you know, there was a target audience that you had to think about, or what words you used, or pictures. And so I was hooked.
And where was your first job?
Well, my first job was actually as an intern at General Foods, which is now Kraft. I worked in the Maxwell House division. And then I went on, when I graduated from business school, I was an assistant product manager at Clairol.
Very good. And when did you get to the advertising agency business?
So when I was at Clairol, it became obvious that the most exciting part of the day was when the agency came. And it wasn't because the agency were such charming, funny, interesting people, which they were, but it was because you could sort of see the ideas come to life. You'd talk about strategy, or you'd be debating positioning, and then all of a sudden, these very interesting, creative people would come through the door, and they would show you what it actually meant, felt like, how they would represent an idea. And you'd go, God, this is great. This is what it's really all about. This is what when marketing actually gets manifest in a stimulus to which people can respond. And so, but I went to the agency side thinking I'd stay 2 years maybe. And I just never left.
First agency job?
Was at Ogilvy. So I was at Clairol. I had done the client bit for 2 years. I was going to go to the agency side, do the agency bit for 2 years. And Ogilvy was a great place to go. And I just kind of fell in love with it. I fell in love with the agency business. I fell in love with Ogilvy. I fell in love with my clients. I fell in love with the people I work with. And I just never left. And that's actually my whole life story.
Now, when many people look at a successful executive like you, they always, many of them think that it's always been easy and business is always going the right direction. As you look back on your career, what was your greatest setback?
Well, I don't think I had a particular setback. I think every time we lost a piece of business, it was really personal. You know, everyone says it's not personal, it's business. It's always personal. And so each time you would sort of feel this rejection from a client to whom you had, you know, devoted so much time and attention, that was always tough. But what I learned was you had to have the resilience, you know, to kind of, it was gonna happen. So you had to have the resilience to bounce back, to say, we are really good at what we do, we add value, we make a difference, and then sort of just go on the next day to going after new clients, or even more importantly, redoubling your efforts against the clients you had. And the truth was, it always worked out. It did. There was either new business, or in most instances, in my case, they came back. And that nothing is more satisfying. As difficult as it is to lose a client, there is nothing more satisfying than when the phone rings and it's your old client who basically says, can we come back now?
Now, as you look back at your career again, notwithstanding that there's more accomplishments for you ahead, okay, but what would be perhaps the greatest accomplishment that you would point to in your career?
Well, you know, I inherited a culture and a point of view from one of the greats in advertising, David Ogilvy. And the thing I'm most proud of is that we are still David Ogilvy's agency. You know, that we've managed to maintain that core of beliefs, of values, of principles that were his and which he started with, you know, back in the late 50s. And while we're a very different agency today from what David's agency was in 1950, at our core, we're the same. At our core, we believe the same things, we value the same things, and the culture that David started from the first day is perhaps stronger today than it even was when he started out. And that's not easy to do, and I'm really proud, actually, that we are who we are today.
So again, looking at the industry, what do you think has been the greatest transformation of it over the last 20 years, and how do you feel you've played a role in that?
Well, I mean, obviously, the role of technology and new media has had an extraordinary impact on the industry. When I first started out in this industry, the task at hand for any client was kind of, you know, do two television commercials and three print ads, and then you would argue about whether it should go in Good Housekeeping or Ladies Home Journal, or whether you should do prime time, or you could just do daytime and late night, and then you could go to lunch and you know, have a martini. It's what's really changed most profoundly are the media choices to use kind of maybe a dated word, a dated term. But if you can think it up these days, you can do it. And so it's really very exciting. As long as you're comfortable with ambiguity and complexity, you're going to have a ball at this time in our business. The trick, though, is to have some orientation, and I think one of the things, again, that I've been very lucky with at Ogilvy is that we've always had a client orientation, which means that we've always had a brand orientation, which means that in a certain sense we've always been sort of discipline agnostic, because the view is whatever is available to a client to build their brands will be something that we have to know how to do. We have to know how to either create it or access it or source it in some way. And so as all the new media came along, the most natural thing in the world for us at Ogilvy was to embrace each new one, because we had to figure out how that could be valuable to a client trying to build a brand. And so while there's been all this sort of a revolution in media, our approach has always stayed the same, because we kind of had to get there before it was important. You know, we had Ogilvy Interactive before there was an internet, which was always difficult to explain in a budget meeting. You know, it's sort of, why do you have these people? Well, because we think there's going to be interactivity. We don't know exactly what it's going to look like, but it's going to be here. And therefore, we need to have people now who understand how to use interactivity for brand building. And so, you know, we woke up one morning, and when everyone else was kind of wringing their hands and going, oh my God, what are we going to do about like this digital thing? What are we going to do about targeting? We had all this stuff. You know, we just had to sort of slightly readjust it. You know, so we always had Ogilvy Direct, which morphed into Ogilvy One, which was always about targeting and what turned into digital. And the internet was an obvious place to go when you were trying to target people, you know, one at a time. And so, yes, everything's changed, but it's, for us, has been a rather natural evolution.